Now, courses can be made either from the front end or the back end of the online academy. At both the ends, the interface is same for the course creation and managing the courses. So, for the sake of demonstration, let us see how to create a course. Since I am logged in as administrator of this academy, I have this manage menu. I click this to go to the back end of the academy. Here, click the learning content, and then in the sub menu, click the courses. Then in this page, you will see three template of courses, namely Quick Course, Thorough Online Course, and Drip Course, which are present by default to help you out to make courses during the initial stages of your learning curve to understand the online course making. But if you are already well versed with the way an online course is structured, just click the new course and choose the blank course. Now, for example, I make a course with the name Basics of Hydraulics. Then, as you can see, this course name Basics of Hydraulics is created and it will appear on top of other courses. Now, let me tell you that all these courses, including the template courses, are completely editable. That is, you can change their names and settings along with the course content. Now, first see what all can be done from this page vis-a-vis the courses. So, if you come here, where you can see a menu by clicking,
where first you will find edit menu,
which is the learning content of this course. That is, by clicking this item, we can go to the page where we can add chapters, lectures, exercise files, quizzes. That is the content of this course. Then comes the discussions, where you can see what all interactions are happening with the learners of the course. Then below it is reviews of the course, which are visible publicly and is a powerful tool for the marketing of the course. You can delete any unwanted review as well. Then comes the settings, which would be mostly required during the creation of the course, as you can do naming,
putting the description,
pricing, publishing the course through this menu, which we will see soon after. Then below this comes the copy course, which will copy this course with its content and settings, which you may later on prune and edit, rename it to create another online course in a faster manner, which might be having some of the learning content like that of the mother course. This functionality is good for creating courses
from
chunks of another bigger course. Then obviously the delete course
option,
which will delete your course, though we recommend to use it very judiciously, as it would permanently delete the course. So instead of deleting the course, try using unpublishing the course through the settings. For the sake of demonstration, we see the settings and content creation for the quick course. Clicking the quick course,
and you land on the course builder page or curriculum, where
you can see that a course is structured with different chapters. These are chapters, like the first one has the name Let's Get Started, then another chapter name is Introduction, then another chapter is named as What's Next. So these are the chapters, and each chapter has lectures. Similarly, you can have quizzes and assignments also in each chapter along with the lectures. You can have n number of lectures, n number of quizzes, and n number of assignments in each chapter. And in a course, you can have n number of chapters there. Then in each lecture, you can have downloadable files. But first, let me show you that all chapters and lectures are completely rearrangeable like this. Then again, the chapter can be moved. So the curriculum is like pick and drop. You may delete the lectures, quizzes, assignments like this. Click OK, then it will get deleted. You can delete the whole chapters from here. But it is advisable to unpublish them instead of deleting. You may add new lectures, quizzes, and chapters from here You can add new lectures. You can add new quiz. You can add assignments.
And from the bottom, you can add chapter like this. Again, you can see the new chapter has been created. I can add lectures, quiz or assignments to it.
Now, let us check what to do in the settings of a course. From here, I can go to the settings. This is the setting of the course. And from here, I can go back to the content. Now, please remember that each course is unique. So, each course has its own settings and it should not be confused with the academy settings, which is for whole academy and can be done from here. Here, you have the settings for the academy. This is for an individual course in your academy. Now, in the course setting, we have
five
steps of basic, pricing, SEO, which means search engine optimization, advanced, and publish. The content which will be filled in the basic and the pricing tab will be visible in the landing page of the course, which is publicly visible, and you can see it simultaneously while editing the basic tab. The course name, description, and the course image can be edited here along with what we learn and course preview link. In the course description, we can add text, images, videos, and even HTML. This description will be visible below the course name and should give synopsis of the course along with what the learner will learn in what we learn. In the course preview link, you can put the link of an introductory video of your course.
By the way, just remember,
you can make any of your lectures available for preview to the visitors
from that particular lectures editor itself,
which acts as a marketing tool for the course. Then you can choose the category of the course, but by default, if you do not choose any category, then it would be categorized as all course. From here, you can make the new category. Then from here, you can choose the teacher and the assistant teachers. The assistant teacher can only interact with the students but cannot edit the course. Then further, you may choose the level of the course. Further down, you can select multiple categories of the course provided you have made them. It means that you can have a course
which has multiple categories. After making the changes, do remember to click the update button.
Then coming to the pricing tab, you can click this radio check button to either set the course as a free course, one-time payment course, or time-based subscription course. If you select the option of free, then further you can select whether it should be free for all or should be free for those students who have taken other courses. Like if I select this checkbox, then it gives me option to select the available other courses, the student of which can access
this as free course.
This option can work when you wish to give some supplementary courses free along with a paid course. And you may mention that in the course description, which may lure the visitor to take your paid course with which this course comes for free. You may further select more than one course in this list by pressing Ctrl key. Then you can set your course as a lifetime access course for a one-time fee by selecting this one-time payment option. Here, you can set an original price and a sale price, where the sale price would be the actual price which a student will pay for enrolling your course, while the original price will appear as strike-through price besides the sale price
on your course landing page.
This again is a marketing tool for your course, showing the rebate available. Then further down, third option for setting the price of a course is the subscription, where you give access to a course for a particular time.
For example, you may choose an advanced plan, set a price, then further you may put what should be the renewal plan of this course. Then further you may choose any of the plans as the default plan. All these plans can be made again from the academy settings from here.
So that was the pricing. Now, after the pricing comes the SEO tab. SEO means search engine optimization. It is one of the most important organic marketing tool. As you might be aware that a proper search engine optimization lets other to find you through the search engines like Google, Bing, etc. This will not only bring organic traffic to your course landing page, but also reduce your advertisement costs. So in this tab, you have three fields to fill, namely SEO title, where you need to fill the course title,
as will be shown in the search result.
This could be different from the actual course name, which you have given in the basic tab of the course setting. Then below the SEO title, you have the SEO description. It will appear as text below the title in the search engine results. Then below that comes the course keywords, which requires a bit of imagination from your side, as you need to think and write all those keywords which you believe someone would search with, like each chapter and lecture name and synonym of them could be a keyword or whatever you may think which is related to the course of yours. That could be a keyword, and all keywords have to be separated by commas. You may have to tweak the keyword and description and even title from time to time to tune the relevant traffic coming to your course page. As a good practice, please press update
after you finish making the changes.
Now, after SEO tab, we come to the advanced tab, in which we can set few more but important aspects of the course. First, we can set whether the student can access the course lectures randomly or sequentially through these two buttons, or whether the course would be a drip course. Now remember, with the settings of random and sequential, all the course lectures, quizzes and assignments will be downloaded to the student panel at once, and obviously a student can access the lectures randomly or sequentially depending on the settings you choose. But for a drip course, the lectures will appear after the specified period. This period can be set date wise or interval wise in days.
In a newly created course, option to randomly access the lectures is set as default.
Then below is the final quiz option, where you may select any quiz of the course as the final condition to mark a course as completed by the student. Since there are no quiz added here
in this course,
no option is coming. But if you add the quizzes, it will give you the option to select any one of them as final quiz. That is, you can choose any one of the quiz to be set as final condition to be passed by the learner to mark the course completed. This is like final exam where the learning is assessed. Then last is the option of course certificate, where in the drop down you can select any one of the condition which must be fulfilled for the certificate to be awarded to the learner, or you may select the option of no certificate of the course. Then finally, in the publish tab, you can publish or unpublish the entire course. You can also publish or unpublish individual lectures, quizzes and assignments. Please remember that as a default, your lectures, quizzes and courses are set as published. So remember to unpublish them when you are still drafting them.
Once you are finished making changes, do not forget to press the update button.
Now we shall see the creation of learning content, that is lectures, quizzes, assignments in a course. So before we begin, let me show you that we can access the course content, which is the learning content,
from several places.
So here, if we go click the edit content and go directly to edit the content, or you can click the course name
to go to the main page of the course content, which is also called curriculum of the course.
Then again, if we go to the setting, as we have seen previously, you can click the course content from here
to reach the curriculum page.
So let me just remind you once more that all these content, the names of the lecture and the courses, are editable
along with its content, and we have given a structure in the three template courses to help you learn the way an online course is made.
A course is divided in several chapters, and each chapter can have several lectures, quizzes, and assignments. In lectures, learning content can be put in the form of videos, PDFs, audio files, text, HTML, flash files, and then a jump button also, which helps you to make a simulation sort of online course. And then again in the quizzes, several formats of questions like multiple choice question, match the pair, or multimedia question can be put. So you can create a new chapter from here by clicking the add chapter. You have to put a title. Say I put post summary, a chapter is created with the name post summary. Then inside this chapter, I can create a lecture through this button, or add quiz, or add assignments. Remember, I can add n number of these elements. Like I am creating a new lecture inside this chapter, giving it a name. Then select the media format, if it is a video or PDF or doc, audio or text. By default, it comes as video.
Please note that selecting video in this field will give you functionality to add only one video lecture. Nevertheless, it does not mean that you cannot add videos with other option, as that can be done by adding the paragraph element in our pick and drop lecture editor.
Then put the duration of that lecture, which is just for display for the course, from its landing page and has nothing to do with any functionality. But say when you put any video, automatically that video's period will be taken by the system and will be displayed. Similarly, you can add a quiz from here, give it a name, select the level and the duration. Now here, this duration of the test is also not relevant, as time allowed for the quiz to be finished by the learner is set inside the quiz. This duration has to be mentioned in the unit of hours only.
At this juncture, please note that the order of the chapters and all of its elements like lecture, quizzes and assignments can be reordered in a pick and drop fashion from the curriculum page itself. And evidently, you can also delete any chapter, lecture, etc. through this cross sign from the curriculum page of the course.
But it is always advisable to unpublish them, as you will lose the content in it unless it has been added in your media library or question bank.
Further, by clicking on this icon of a chapter, you can edit its name and publish or unpublish it.
But for the lectures, quizzes and assignment, clicking this sign will take you to its editor, where you may also publish or unpublish the lecture along with editing the content in it.
As I have clicked the lecture, which is a text type of lecture, here you can see I can publish or unpublish the lecture through this checkbox, and the lecture can be set for preview by the visitors who come on the course landing page. It means that they can see the lecture without subscribing the course. It could be used as a sales pitch or as a sample lecture. Now let's see the editor. Here in the lecture editor, this area is called container, in which templates can be made by picking and dropping the layouts inside it, and then picking and dropping the various elements like paragraph, image, audio, PDF, HTML, flash, and jump button in the template. Further, the template can be saved to be used in other lectures.
But say you want to make the lecture a video only lecture, you can click a video and the template will change from here. You can directly upload a video, putting an app title and choosing the video from your computer. When you add a new video with the title, after the upload is complete, the file will be converted, and when the video is ready, it can be selected from the media library. As a default, there are some medias which are present here. Then further, you can put an outside video with the video URL, say from Vimeo or YouTube, or you can embed the code from the YouTube or Vimeo here. Then below this, you can see a downloadable file section. Students in each lecture can be provided a downloadable file. It could be a zip, it could be a PDF, or anything as per your wishes. Then for that, either you can select it from the existing files or you can add a new downloadable file. Once you attach a new downloadable file, it will not only get attached to this lecture ready for being downloaded by the learners, but also would be added in the media list to be used in some other lecture or course hereafter. Now remember that in the elements we do not have the video, but say if you want to put the video,
you just have to drag the element of paragraph,
click it, and from inside this you can insert a video.
For having just a video lecture,
obviously you have to select from the type and select the video from here.
With this template, as we have seen earlier, a single video lecture can be made.
Further, you can copy a layout from here, so whatever elements are there in it will also get copied. Like if I am copy here, this new layout has appeared. Coming to the elements, we have format like paragraph, image, audio, gallery, PDF,
HTML code,
flash,
and
jump button.
Let's see the functionalities of all these elements one by one.
So let's make a single element layout, and we shall see each element by dragging them inside this container. So first we are taking a paragraph. In the paragraph editor, you can not only put texts in different formats, but also put mathematical equations from this icon, which could be a very useful tool for STEM courses. Then further, you can insert video, images, outside links, and once you finish editing, click apply changes and the paragraph will appear. Similarly, for the audio element, you can upload the file from your computer.
And then select the uploaded file from the media library.
You can then orient the player's position to right, left, or center. Not to overemphasize that after editing, you can preview from here. And if satisfied, click the update to save the changes. Now, I am adding a gallery element in which you can add multiple images and play an image slider as the content. Similar is the case for PDF element, where you can upload a new PDF document
and select the uploaded PDF from the media library.
And third option is to put the URL of the PDF so that from a third party page, the PDF can be inserted as the learning content of the lecture. Then sixth element is the code, which lets you enter the HTML code as content for the lecture. This opens a wide range of possibility for the quality of learning content, from a simple text, image, video, to a
rich content.
So, for example, I am putting a code here, clicking the apply changes. This HTML has come.
And then
I have to click the update. Then similar is the element of Flash, where you can add a Flash file from your computer, and once you upload, like other medias, it will show up in the media library, or you can insert a Flash URL. Then last element is the jump button. Jump button will link itself to another lecture of the same course or to another course, and will let the course to be designed as a simulation or like a game. You can name this button
by putting an apt title,
which will serve its purpose to make the learners click it. For example, you can make a career selector as a course, where each lecture may have one or several jump buttons, and it leads the learner to a suitable career option advice as per his or her preferences, which are mentioned as a paragraph element besides the
aptly titled jump button.